Hi friends, welcome back. And exactly a year back when we started speaking about Brightcom Group, the basic thought process which what I started was that when I started seeing this company, the company's original name was Lycos Internet, right? And if you have been tracking this share for a very long period of time, you would be knowing this company name was Lycos Internet Limited. Then the company name changed to Brightcom Group Limited, right? And that is the first phase that I want to discuss with you. And the second thing that I want to discuss with you regarding what are the three important things that has happened over the period of almost maybe 2 to 2.5 weeks. Maybe 3 years back, the share price I believe was in the range of around 6 rupees, 7 rupees, etc. Now it is breaking the shutters of the new market high capitals and going up to 31.65 on a price basis. On a price basis alone, and what I'm trying to say now, kind of understand, on a price basis alone. From the date of listing in the market, the highest price the company has achieved was 40 rupees, right? And I think since they have settled out this Axis Bank debt, I think now, as they say, they are debt free. That's the first thing. The second thing here is that raising of funds is they declared the dividend of 5 paise and they also issued a bonus of 1:4. Let us keep those things away. And if you are going to focus on this 1500 crores of fundraise, what the company has said in this quarter result, right? You would see after those events a beautiful thing happened. And what is this beautiful thing, if you ask me? The board is having a meeting on July 13th, which means coming July 13th, the board is having a meeting in order to decide the LOA and the additional capital required to propose for the acquisition plans and the preferential issues to the specific individual entities, etc. That is the first thing. And if you go again to a beautiful date, Brightcom Group to acquire a leading digital marketing services company, right? And this acquisition of this digital marketing services company, which is having almost 1,100 employees, and they are working for Netflix, Disney, Bitly, Hulu, and the New York Times. I think this acquisition pace at which Brightcom Group is going to be very important, right? And I already said to you why the 40 rupees is very important. The date of listing was just 40 rupees, and from that level it has gone up to 4 rupees, 5 rupees, etc. And it has been a good revive by Brightcom Group. Courtesy, if you ask me, preferential allotment has been made at low prices and the price has now started to rise. And if you have seen the 1500 crores of fundraise that Brightcom Group is going to do, but the current market capital of the company stands at 1600 crores, right? So somewhere it is hitting us, right? Yes, because the total market capital is just 1500 crores. How can the company raise 1500 crores? So which means basically there's a long way run for this company to go, and that is the way we have been waiting for almost a year from right now, right? And if you ask me what is the level at which the share price can stop running, or what is the price that one could book some profit, if you ask me, basically always see the business category, right? And how they entered this audio based marketing services, and now they acquired the digital services related. They are going on organic growth as well as on inorganic growth through acquisition mode. That is really important. I just want to quote a simple stance here. I mean, usually I don't want to cover about this Reliance Infra stocks, etc., but it becomes very important. I believe Reliance Infra was in the price of around 19 rupees. It has surged above 100 rupees right now. But if you clearly notice what was the rise, when the price was just 50 rupees or 55 rupees, there was a preferential allotment that was made at premium to the market price, I believe at 63 rupees or 65 rupees, which propelled the share price to go to a higher level. If, for an example, I don't know whether this is going to happen, if the July 13th regarding the fundraise, the talks which has been set aside, if the shares are to be going to be allotted at a premium, right, the share will automatically cross those premium levels and go at a high level. Or whether if they are going to give out a discount to the current share price, like how all banks do, right? If that is going to be the case, I believe it could have a sustained momentum. Okay, now can I enter this range, if you ask me? Basically it depends upon at what kind of risk level that you wish to take, right? If you ask me that, I would enter. If I feel comfortable, I would enter. whether if you have entered, whether you are comfortable to enter at this level, if you ask me, when comparing those financials, earning a profit of almost maybe 100 to 400 crores per year, and since the company is now debt free since they settled out this Axis Bank loan issues, I believe maybe this price can suitable for me, or it could be suitable for me. But it does not depends upon all the persons who are holding, who I want to buy, would be comfortable. But on a business basis, it is pretty strong, and they are going on a acquisition pace. So which means indirectly the revenue is going to increase, and indirectly the profitability is also going to increase, and which can show in the terms of share price and the EPS for this company. I mean, the share has not even tested the book value finally till now after this 1 month of rise. Let's see how much long is going to go. Thank you, friends, and bye.